When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome to Chef Motrain's Kitchen here on Motrain TV. I'm gonna cook you a little feast tonight.
A bottle of red. A bottle of
first
white.
Of all, can't have a feast without starting off with a little bit of vino. Tonight I decided to reward myself with a little bit of Mondavi-Rothschild Opus One, 2000 vintage. If you know wine, you know this one. Wait, it's so good, I might have to get another look here. Ready? Here it is. Opus 2000. So, what I'm cooking tonight, I wasn't making myself a bunch of tuna. I was making myself pepper tuna with soba noodles, but they didn't have enough tuna, so I decided to change a little bit. And I am making mango chicken. Nice melons.
Ass, titties, ass and titties.
Anyway, so I'm gonna half these mangoes. I'm gonna reduce one of the mangoes into a sauce. Get myself a little teriyaki. Add myself some ricin, ginger, garlic, pepper. But anything else I have, you know what? I gotta take this hat off. Hold on. Alright, it's better. So I'm gonna put some whole bunch of spices in. I'm gonna get it going, reduce the mangoes. So yeah, I'm gonna get this started. I'm gonna get the stove going here, start reducing things, start my prep work, and I'll show you how it goes. Back in the kitchen here, we're gonna start off with getting a sticker off this damn mango. I know you're all probably thinking, what, can't get the sticker off the mango, how's he supposed to cook? Well, here we go. Got the mango. I'm gonna half it right now. I'm taking out the pit. Oh shit. What the shit? Alright, well, that wasn't supposed to happen. What a shitty mango I got. Ah. Alright, well. This has a very... What the hell? Alright. This is a mango that's gonna be sauce because look at that shit. My god. Yeah, this mango's seen better days. This mango officially sucks. Like, bad. Oh my god, what a horrible fucking mango. Alright, this one's going. That is all fucking. It's all pit! Where's the meat? Where is the meat? I'm looking for meat here, alright? You know what? I'll put the whole fucking thing in there. Get all the meat out. There we go. I gotta turn it down a little bit. Might add a little Chinese cooking wine to this. Cut all the way through that piece. Now that's what's supposed to happen. That's kinda... Never mind. There we go. See? That's what's supposed to happen. That last mango is ridiculous. See what we got? Yeah. Alright, everyone. There it is again. Ouch. Yeah. Don't cut towards your hand.
now we've got two halves. Just the mango, what we're going to do, we're going to take these mangoes and we're going to use them as serving cups. Presentation. As soon as this mango breaks down, start adding some seasonings, add a little teriyaki, some cracked pepper, sriracha for all you hot fans out there. Cook that up. Alright, so these are going to the side, and this is for you. Motrain TV is also brought to you by Jägermeister. Not just a small bottle, but the big one. So here we go. We got the half mangoes. Like I said, we're gonna keep these. Where are we? Wait, this way. What the fuck am I doing? All right, this way. We're gonna keep these to put the chicken back into and put mango pieces back into. And the sauce. So we're gonna put these off to the side. Let me grab a paper towel here. These paper towels are horrible too. What am I doing here? What am I doing? These paper towels are horrible. Look at this shit. Look, I'm trying to cook here. I'm dealing with this crap. Look. All right, time for the chicken. Since you always tell me you said to cook at least an hour, how long does it say? What's it say on here?
Oh, no.
Aw. Just shot one on me. Oh, fuck. There we go. Another half. Right here. Saucepan reducing. Once it breaks down, I'll be able to work with it more. You have the mangoes breaking out very nicely here. Breaking down into a sauce. All this is just pure mango broken down. See, the sugars of the mango plus a bit of rice wine vinegar. Oh, sorry, bit of cooking wine, which I'm going to add a little bit more. And if... one love. I don't know if you can hear what song is on, but... One Love, my favorite song. Always reminds me of... well, you. Back to cooking. Alright. Let's mix this up a bit. How's it smell? It smells so good. Now I'm going to do the appetizer. I am going to make pepper tuna. I'm going to rare sear the tuna. Well, first of all, if you're going to rare sear tuna, you have to get sashimi grade tuna or else I wouldn't do it, I was going to get sick. So sashimi grade tuna, pretty expensive, but it's worth it. You need to get the pan nice and hot. When you rare sear tuna, you only need to do the tuna for about, I don't know, depending on how hot the pan is, you can do it for 30 seconds or even less. Okay, so I've gone ahead and discarded all the mango pulp. Now it's coming down to nice liquid. This is all broke down. I'm gonna keep it on low heat on the stove. Add a little olive oil to the pan. Not fishy tuna is very important. If it smells fishy, throw it away. Got my pepper grinder. Ow. All right, suck up all that pepper. Gotta wait for the pan to get nice and hot. Now I'm gonna start cooking the chicken. Cooking the chicken, this is the fat-free chicken. I like to eat healthy, so. God, it's hot in here. Whew. Anyway, chicken is real thin, so it needs to cook for about 3 minutes, if that. So I'm gonna cook that pretty soon. Waiting for the pan to get hot with for the tuna. Tuna, I'm gonna sear it real quick. Ready for that, cut it nice and thin. Get a nice marinade going for that. Oh, it's so damn good. Phenomenal, it's phenomenal. Time to multitask here. I've got the water going, I've got the oil going. If I get this close, probably with my luck, I'll probably splatter it in the face. And I got the reduction going. So I'm starting to reduce, starting to thicken a little bit. I'm supposed to use a little cornstarch for that, but I don't have any, so. I'll deal with it. I'm gonna use some ingredients you might have in your house. For one, I got hoisin. Hoisin's a staple in some Asian cooking. That, and for all you Jewish people out there, I've got very airy teriyaki. Damn good stuff. It's soy vey. If you see that in the store, pick it up. It's great.
Cool.
Hoisin in with the mango reduction. Gonna have the sauce on fairly low so it doesn't burn the sauce. Gonna add some freshly ground pepper to that as well. It smells so good in here, you wish you were here. Well, you will be here, so. A little olive oil. Just a little bit. Gonna add some roasted sesame seeds. Another thing you get from the Asian market. Give it a little roasted sesame flavor. Wait, what? Which way the gun show? Now we're gonna add a little bit of oyster sauce. I don't know if you can read this, but oyster flavored sauce, food for connoisseur. Come on. And the soy vey. All right, two very important ingredients. One is the minced ginger. And what kind of language this is, I have no idea. Because, I don't know. And this is just some chopped garlic. I was gonna get some fresh garlic, but cook enough right here. Don't get greedy. Put about a tablespoon, about a half a tablespoon of ginger into the sauce. Ginger's damn good, so I'm gonna put another half in. And the garlic, I'm gonna put about a teaspoon in there. God, you don't know how good this kitchen smells. Holy shit. Nah, smoking isn't here either. Turn up the tuna in, now watch. Right now, it's 9:30. Now watch that. I'll have my tongs with a French serve it. Set. That's it. That's how it's done. See, all you need is about that much cook for rare tuna. Remember, it's gotta be good quality tuna or else don't do it. This is extra rare, but remember, sashimi grade tuna should be kept rare. Motherfucker! Ah! Holy shit! Oh my god! Alright, that wasn't supposed to happen. There we go. There it is. Fully seared and then burned the fuck out of my finger.
Wow, it's smoky in here. Yeah, that was too much. That was too much grease. Fuck! Anyway. For those with grease burns, just make sure you run your finger under cold water. You want to make sure the sauce can coat a spoon. That's when most sauces are ready. Alright, have my tuna ready. Now I'm going to prepare my marinade for the tuna.
Now that we've got the tuna cooked, we're going to take the tuna and slice it down thinly. Get a nice sharp knife. See, that's about how much the tuna's been cooked. Barely. Enough to sear the flavor in. So, I mean, if you want, you should cook against the grain. We should cut against the grain. Nice thin slices. There we go. Now, two things that stay together. Use just a little bit of teriyaki. Some more ginger. Ginger's key for this. This is tuna au poivre with a ginger teriyaki sauce. Fair amount.
I told you I could cook.
I mean, you've seen me cook before, but.
Oh, it's so fucking hot in here. Shit.
Ow, fucker!
Oh! burnt the shit on my hand again with some grease. And why am I wearing a fucking black shirt to cook with?
I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut the chicken into small pieces so it can go into the mango shells. Make sure you have a sharp knife. Cut right through. Shut up! Alright. We have the half mango shells that I took out earlier, about, oh shit, about an hour and a half ago. And what we're gonna do, we fill it with the pieces of mango and chicken. So we're going to intersperse them. Mango and chicken. Mixed in. And all the mango halves. So you have the mango and the chicken in the mango halves. I'm gonna do a little alteration with appetizers. I'm gonna put the tuna around the rim. So you can start with that before you go to the chicken. Now you take the sauce, which has been reducing for a while. Right into each mango shell. Healthy choice fucking sucks. I'm telling you, I had two scoops, two forkfuls, and I was done. Now come on. So healthy choice, right there. And what else I have in my freezer? A frozen NWO cup.
Told you it was rabbit.
What's up, rabbit?
There they are. Let's see how close I can get to these things. What's up, rabbits? Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do?